Hello, and welcome to this edition of ICN. I'm your host, Dylan Henson. Coming up, we'll discuss the North Carolina budget, a new food pantry on campus, and election results from this year's municipal election, and also an upcoming light show coming to our area. But first, this week's opening was produced by BP2 student Zach Powell. For our top story today, there's a gridlock in Raleigh as Governor Cooper clashes with the state legislature to pass the annual budget. Here's Carmen Huffman with more details.
That's right, Dylan. The conflict over the budget really picked up this summer when Governor Cooper vetoed the $24 billion version of the budget that had been passed by Republicans in the General Assembly. On September 11th, Republicans overrode the governor's veto in controversial fashion, calling a vote while the majority of Democrats were not in session. Many Democrats have criticized the vote for being sly and undemocratic. The major concern is that the budget has been an increase in teacher salaries, as well as an expansion in Medicaid. Since then, the General Assembly has been gone into recess and reconvened without addressing the issue of budget. Failure to pass a budget on by January 1st will result in government-funded programs being shut down.
Looking for some festive activities to do this month, the Tron Equestrian Center is getting in their holiday spirits by giving the people a drive-through light show. The lights will be open from the public from November 15th and continue through January 5th, and it's $25 a car. The show will start from 6 to 10 p.m. on Mondays through Fridays and 6 to 10 p.m. or later on Saturdays or Sundays. The lights cover a 2-mile show and will dance along to the radio station that is set at the Equestrian Center. This event is expected to be very busy on Saturdays and Sundays, so be sure not to miss out on this terrific event. Main Street Market, located in Ruffton, is teaming up with Beyond to help this nonprofit local businesses. They are also becoming a part of the Chip In program. It's an app you can get on your phone, and after you put in your credit card information, anything you purchase from the store will be donated to nonprofit organizations in our region. To learn more about donating to this awesome cause, visit www.donate.chip-in.us. This week's Hometown Heroes has a very special place in our hearts. They have served our country through without fear or failure and secured our modern freedoms. Here's Elena Good with more details.
Our hometown hero this week goes out to all the veterans who have served or are currently serving. Isothermal Community College would like to take this time to appreciate those who are willing to put their lives out on the line. From World War I to World War II to the Vietnam War to the Afghanistan War, we appreciate your service. It takes a special hero with a selfless personality and therefore a tremendous love for our nation. This week, take some time to thank a veteran in your family or even a friend. Make sure to tell them, never forget. It is a sign that we will always remember their amazing sacrifices for you and your nation. Thank you to all veterans. We appreciate your service and willingness and commitment to our great country.
In the spirit of Thanksgiving, Phi Beta Lambda has opened the doors to the food pantry in room 120 of the Business's Sciences Building. They offer basic items such as non-perishable foods and personal care items. The pantry is open from students and employees of the college, and you must have either a student ID or a current class schedule in order to shop at the pantry. If you have time, volunteers are appreciated and donations are also helpful. The pantry is open on Mondays from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. and Thursdays from 12 p.m. to 4 p.m. For more information, contact Rebecca Haney or Amy Gala. The pantry is closed whenever the college is closed. The 2019 municipal elections have come and gone, and here are some of the results. Keith Dobbins and Shane Upton and Roger Hall were elected as commissioners for the town of Bostick. For the four city commissioner elections, Dee Dee Griffith-Bright, Chris Lee, and Justin Connor were victorious. Lake Lure elected David R. Diario and Patrick O'Brien to commissioners. The town of Ruth elected William Stepe to serve as their commissioner. And the Ruth mayoral elections, the write-in candidates received more votes, but Buchanan won. The town of Spindle elected Hamilton, Walker, and Harmon to serve as their commissioners. And the town of Ruffton had an election for councilmen. Henry Giles and Douglas Sheets were victorious. In the village of Chimney Rock, Shields, O'Leary, and Robson won the councilmen. The incumbent mayor of Ellenboro, Jim Ryan, was elected for another term. Gillikin and Weeks were also successful in Ellenboro, winning the two seats for alderman. Well, that's all that we have for today. Make sure to like us on Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel, Isothermal TV. And from everyone here at the broadcasting department, we hope you have a great day.